This is the solution to quiz three. Okay. So, x1 minus x2. So that is to say, let's draw between the heads of x1 and x2, and then we want to do the one that does the opposite of x2 and the same as x1. So that means go opposite x2, same as x1. So then that's this. So that's negative x2 plus x1. And then add to it x3. So that is negative x2 plus x1. And add to that x3. Ah, but well, I was supposed to name that u according to the instructions. So according to the instructions, that's u, and this is u plus x3. Okay. Okay. So now let's add these together. It says x1 plus x3. And we're supposed to refer to that as v, and then we're supposed to do v minus x2. Okay, well, here's two vectors with their tails together, and since it's the opposite of x2, that means we'll do opposite of x2 and then the same as v. So that's negative x2 plus v. Okay. Okay, well, on the left-hand side, every vector has a canceling anti-parallel vector. So these are all paired up. So as a result, the answer here is just a single point. This is the zero vector, the sum of all of those. And then this, all of the ones are paired up except for this one, which has been deleted, so all that's left is that one that doesn't have a partner to cancel it. Okay, so that's the answer to part B. Okay, so you can see that the standard basis E1 followed by E2 has a counterclockwise direction, but the matrix M applied to E1 does this, and then M applied to E2 does that. So as a result, this is going that direction. And that's the entire geometric argument, that the sign of the determinant is negative. So the determinant of M is negative. Because its orientation is clockwise. Okay, now argue that the determinant is more than 2. Well, this here is the unit square. And I can see at least two copies of it right there, at least two of them, and a little more, in fact. So there's more than 2. So, see, figure. Finally, determine the matrix of M. Well, and compute its determinant. Well, ME1, according to the picture, you can see that from the tail to the head of ME1, it goes over 1 and up 3. So ME1 is is 1, 3. And then ME2, it goes right 2 and up 1. And therefore, the matrix of M is just those columns. 1, 3, 2, 1. And therefore, the determinant of M is, well, it's what? 1, and then minus 6 is negative 5. Okay. Number 3. Okay, draw two vectors with their tails in the same place. So for part A, well, I'll just do it all. This doesn't need to be a right triangle. So I'll call this X and this Y. Draw XY. Okay, so the difference goes from head to head. And we want it to be opposite of Y, same as X. So opposite of Y, same as X. Now use the triangle inequality. Okay. So that's A and B. See, according to the triangle inequality, we want to obtain this. So we want to add two of them together. So we'll add these two together. So well, absolute value of X, length of X is less or equal to length of X minus Y plus Y. So that's the triangle inequality. Just taking the two of those together. And therefore, we can move the y to the other side and get x minus y less or equal to x minus y. Okay. And that's, so that's C, and this is D.